So I got my hands on GPT-4 with ChatGPT, as you can see up here, model GPT-4. And we asked it to build a supply and demand zone algorithm, and it built it for us, which is pretty crazy. As you can see, here's all of the code for trading Ethereum, actually Bitcoin, with supply and demand zones. Now, if you aren't already caught up, a supply and demand zone is this is kind of the demand zone down here near these wicks, and the supply zone's kind of up here. So we're far into this building it, and I've got a lot of work to do, and this is really the only way I can share what I'm doing is by showing you my actual day-to-day. So we're gonna keep running this. I do wanna remind you, if you do wanna win that $500 giveaway, I am giving away $500 on April 4th to one lucky winner who comments and subscribes. So all you have to do is comment and subscribe. And there's gonna be a couple runners up that get free entrance into my algo trade camp, which teaches you exactly how to algo trade step by step. There's a link below. You get 7 full algorithms. But the reason I put that together is because I know my videos are me just working, and it's only the only way I can really share this information to as many people as possible is by just showing you what I do each day. So we're using ChatGPT today in order to build this supply and demand zone. You can see it's already built a ton of it for us, and it helped build this one as well. So let's just keep on chugging through this. And like I said, this is my day-to-day. So I need to fix some errors, and that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna start here. So let's go ahead and say I get this error when I run the code. I'm getting this error. How come? How do I fix this error? Please. And let's go ahead and run it and see what it has to say, because it looks like something might have changed in the last few weeks with something. The error you're encountering is due to a problem while parsing the CSV March 23 tape reader. Specifically, the error indicates that the parser expected 9 fields in the line. Line 111. Okay. But it found 12 fields instead. So in this line, it found 12 fields. This suggests that there might be a formatting issue in your CSV. To fix the error, you can check the CSV to manually correct it. Okay, that could be a solution, but if it's broken, I don't know if we want to do that. Alternatively, you can modify the pd.read CSV function to ignore any lines with formatting issues by using error bad lines. I like that. So, what line is this error on, first off? So, you can see here in line 593. So let's go down to 593 on this code. And I know this is gibberish if you're new to this, but stick around because this is how you learn how to code. And I show you everything in the boot camp as well. So ignore bad lines. Interesting. See, I've never used that before. And that is why ChatGPT is so dope. Ignore bad lines. Well, let's see if this works before I give it too much credit, right? Okay, skipping. Okay, perfect. All right, so this is working now. Perfect, perfect, perfect. We didn't get a buy or sell signal. All right, so this looks great. I'm actually gonna take this and fix it over on my other, since I'm here, might as well just get it done. What is this? 2, 2, 6. And like I said, I'm actually doing my day-to-day here, so I have another screen that I'm actually just gonna fix this error as well, because this error was giving me problems on my live bot, and that's no fun. So I wanna just add it in here, error bad lines. And now that should work on my other algorithm, and let's see if this does. Let's go ahead and run this over here. So I'm running it on my other computer. Okay, it looks like it's working now. Beautiful. So that's amazing, because that would have taken me so long to figure out. I would have had to like Google it, Stack Overflow, etc. So now what do we want to do with this bot? So this essentially finds the supply and demand zones. And now we want to say, but look at BTC when to enter. First, I want to do this. So I've got a long list of things I want to try. Things to try. 15-minute SEZ zone instead of what we're doing. Okay. And we have to figure out what is this algorithm doing right now. So I think I probably wrote about it. So this gets the order book. It is supply and demand zone plus order book, which is good. And I want to tighten it up a little bit. So let's go ahead and look at the supply and demand zones and see which one it's getting. So it's 15 minute supply and demand zone, 15 minute, 15 minute. But how many days is it going based off of? Symbol SD limit, SD SMA. So I'm trying to figure out, so I know it's on a 15 minute, right? Like this, but how many days is it looking backwards or hours? And I think that's SD limit. So SD limit is 200. So what is 200 times 15 minutes? 200 times 15 divided by 4. That's 750 hours divided by 24. Is that 31 days? No. 15 minutes times 200. And you can see, even an idiot can figure this out. So 3,000 minutes, right? 15 minutes times 200 periods. And then divided by 60 equals 50 hours. Okay, so that doesn't sound too bad. But do I want 50 hours? Let's see how far this is. Because 50 hours, so this is about 50 hours here. I think I'm gonna do 24 hours. So let's just double check this. Let's say 24 hours is 24 hours times 4, because there's 4 15 minute segments. So I want to do 96 bars. So let's try that. Let's do that. That's going to be the first test. So I'm just going to change this to 96 bars. 96. Should I do that elsewhere though? No, I'll write really good notes. Change to 96 bars instead of 200, so it's 24 hours looking back on the 15 minute DZ. So this is gonna be an interesting run, because this means it's gonna trade way more. AI. Okay, so change, let's say, what's the date? 3/16. Because the way I run it is, I've already backtested this, it does well, and I want to go ahead and test multiple things now. And I want to actually build out another backtest as well, so I have this on my notes. Let me know if you want to see that on the video. Just say, hey, put the backtest video up there as well. And what I want to do here is, I made that change instead of previous 200 bars. And so it's looking at 24 instead of fixed error causing it to not work. Place orders. I also want to go ahead and look back at all of these different strategies. Look back at all the supply demand zone strats and see which did best. This is like an unlimited game. So you can see I'm kind of all over the place, because there's so many ideas that come to me with algo trading, and I can spend so much time here just building out different algorithms, because it's literally the best use of time. If you've been trading, you know that when you get in a trade, you stare at that trade. What a waste of time. especially if you lose. Over time, you'll probably lose. So why not just use that strategy you have and put it into an algorithm and spend that time coding? That's the way I look at it. Okay, so I think this is pretty good notes. 316.23. Fixed error causing it to not place orders. Change 96 bars instead of 200. So I'm going to go ahead and implement those. Well, I have implemented them. Now I'm just going to go ahead and put it into my bot here on the other side. But first, I want to make sure to update this. So I put in new code every week into my trading bootcamp. So the bootcamp shows you different everything you need to know in order to become an algo trader, even how to code. And then it also gives you 7 algorithms. But then we have a weekly thing that updates. I update different code every single week. So I'm going to put some cool stuff in here, and I'm not quite sure what I'm going to put in right now, but you can see this is like 15 different bots. It says 12, but I keep adding more to it, and I'm just going to keep adding more and more to it. Maybe I definitely will put in this new order book thing. So let's just do that. Let's go ahead and grab all of this. Well, I guess I'll copy all of it. And then we want to go down here. Supply and demand zone. Let's go ahead and say supply and demand. Supply, demand, order book. And let's go ahead and paste in all of this stuff it needs. So let's say supply demand order book dot py, and this is going to be in the bootcamp right now, so I'm just putting it in there just so you have the code. And let's say this is a supply and demand zone algo that uses the order book as well. Let's put all those files that it needs. So let's go ahead and grab them. So March, we need these 3 files here. So I'm going to copy them. Actually, we need more than that. We need the nice funks as well. So nice funks here. Where is that? It's right here. We'll go ahead and put that nice funks file in there as well. So you can see every week I'm adding new stuff into this bootcamp, just because the more that I can build, the faster it'll help you build, right? So you're gonna have different ideas than I do. Nice funks dot py, and let's paste that in there. Let's remove this part so you can just put your keys in there. This is the nice functions file. This is the nice functions file for SDZ order book bot. Let's hit save here. And what else do we need in here? I need to make some of this so it doesn't. Should remove this, don't share config. Let's go ahead and save it. Let's also put a little warning in there because we don't want anybody to just run it. I'm just putting this live now. So let's call this something different. Order book, supply, demand, zone, algo. Perfect, that should be good. And let's go ahead and make sure that all of these are saved so you have access to them. Really don't need access to all of it, but this is the one you need access to. So there you go, you have access to this inside the bootcamp. After you join the bootcamp, there is an offer to become a weekly member and you get all the weekly code. But this is pretty amazing because now you have access to the literal code that I'm setting up on my computer right now to run, and I'm going to be testing it with low amounts of money. And I've backtested it a bit, but you know, there are some things that backtest can't pick up on. So I also, if you want, I'll make the backtest video here on this channel. But this is pretty cool because ChatGPT just helped us figure out a big thing that was messing us up on all the last, or it like died the last couple of weeks. So I'm glad I was able to put that in there. And I think from here, what we want to do is, here are some next steps. And next step is get live, this live on trading comp. And then we also want to fix the other bot, other algo, and make it on the 5 minute, 15 minute too, 15 minute as well. But no, I'm gonna do this one, the next one on the 5 minute. 5 minute, and I'm gonna do, what is 24, let's do 12 hours times 5 minutes. So how do we do that math? 12 times 12. So we're gonna do 5 minute with 144 periods equals 12 hours. So this is pretty dope. ChatGPT is able to build a supply and demand zone bot. We've built this over time here with the first ChatGPT. ChatGPT 4 is even more powerful. It found an error for us that has been causing me a headache, and I just pasted it in there. So this is pretty miraculous, I would say. And I'm gonna get this set up live on my other computer, and let me know if you wanna see me build a back test or what you wanna see next. Now, here's your call to action is if you want to get a chance to win $500 on April 4th, I am sending out $500 USDC to one lucky winner. And that lucky winner, all you have to do to apply is subscribe and comment below. So comment and subscribe and you get a chance to win $500 on April 4th. And then also I'll probably give away a couple entries to the I Will Trade camp. So yeah, I'll see you in that. Either in the I Will Trade Camp Discord, next video, or in the comment section below.